Hi, Insta friends. Welcome to a gab about some stuff. The stuff we're gabbing about today is the Louis Vuitton Bom Dia Mules. We are solidly into summer up here in the Northern Hemisphere, and it's sandal season. It's sandal time, so let's get into these. I purchased these in store at Louis Vuitton in early June 2019. And I don't recall what they cost then, and I don't know if they've been subject to the like 4 price increases that have occurred between then and now. But currently they are listed on the website and in stock at $860. I assume they were around that same ballpark last year. I mean, I doubt they were significantly less. Yep. So that's what I paid for them, and I must say, for the price, I don't know that they're holding up super well. Now, you might know I'm fine with luxury shoes, like especially if I can wear them to most of my life needs, if they're like flats or sneakers or sandals, things like that. But these were not inexpensive, and the wear on them has not been great. So look at the front here. It's quite scratched, so I suspect it's coated in quite a delicate leather, and I'm like, why would you do that, Louis Vuitton? Why would you coat these in that? So look at that, they're pretty scratched up. Summer is really short in Boston too, so I know I've had them for a year, but honestly, that just means I probably wore them for a month and a half, so maybe a total of like 10 times, you know? I don't know that this is amazing for nearly $900 shoes. They probably were $900 after tax and everything. So that's the wear on them. The sole is hard to say because I did have them sold. So, you know, I took them to a cobbler, as I do with just about all of my shoes. So that's nothing different. But style-wise, I do like them a lot. I do find them very easy to match and things like that. So I did get a decent amount of wear out of them. The buckles are still in good shape. You know, nothing's coming wrong with the canvas, which I guess you wouldn't expect from Louis Vuitton canvas anyway. So that's holding up as you might expect. But yeah. Yeah, the leather toe area is in pretty bad shape. I'll especially contrast the wear on these. I'll mention the wear on them because I did get some wear out of them, but because I wear a lot of monogram bags, like Louis Vuitton monogram bags, I don't wear these all the time. I have nothing against wearing monogram and monogram, but sometimes also I just prefer not to. I would sometimes opt not to wear these, even though I could have, because I preferred to carry a monogram bag because it was more appropriate for the situation. So I also have a pair of Birkenstocks, which is the sandals that a lot of people compare the Bom Dia Mules to. This is not the exact style of Birkenstocks that people think when they think of the Bom Dia Mules, but I'm sure you know which one I mean. And these I bought at around the same time, and they are wearing really well in the toe area, like no scratch, nothing like that. Of course, these are made of cork. They are not coated in a delicate leather that you would expect to get scratched, but I wouldn't have expected that leather to get scratched either. So there we are. So these are holding up pretty well. These retail for around $100, $120, depending on where you get them, right? So for bang for buck, I mean, if you wanna, you know, flex and be cute or whatever, obviously these are gonna get you there. But this is also a very respectable option, and I do find that I reach for these quite a lot, and I do pair them with my monogram bags if I'm running out on an errand or just wearing on my bum bag or anything like that. I've already worn them quite a lot this summer, and I wore them plenty last summer. The soles are a little bit gross, so I won't show you, but trust me, there's nothing to show. They're fine. The soles are fine. So yeah, I mean, I'm never one to tell folks how to spend their money and what's worth spending money on. So, you know, if you got it, spend it. If you want them in spite of the fact that they don't wear that well, get them. I enjoy them, and I intend to wear them this summer, every opportunity that I get. So I'm not discouraging the purchase, just being completely honest though, a little bit disappointed with the wear on them, considering you know, that summer is so short here, and I don't wear them all the time because of what I'm saying about the handbag. So that's it. Short and sweet on these. I'm not recommending them. I'm not recommending them. Let me know if you have questions. I'm also curious, you know, I'm saying I don't wear these when I wear monogram, Louis Vuitton monogram bags or any other monogram bags because I just don't prefer to. What are your thoughts on that? Like, would you do multiple monogram pieces? Is that like your vibe? Is that your style? Why or why not? I don't know. Anywhere that I need to wear shoes like this, I feel like a lot of Louis Vuitton is overkill. I'm talking like the farmer's market, like the fabric store, you know, things like that, where like I feel like it's a little excessive. But different strokes, different folks. So let me know what your strokes are. Hope you're well. Gab back, and I'll chat with you next time. Take care, Instafam. Peace.